Scientists. My name is Janae, and I'm a vice president at Learning Undefeated, a nonprofit organization that provides life-changing STEM experiences for students from underserved communities. Do you think that a piece of paper can hold up a book? What about 10 books? What about 30 books? Well, in today's experiment, we're going to test the strength of different geometric shapes by seeing how much weight they can hold.
All you need for today's activity are a couple of small books, some paper, and some tape. That's it. That's all you need for today's experiment. First, you're going to take a piece of paper and you're going to fold it so that it forms a column, a long or tall column that forms a shape. The first shape I'm going to make is a triangle. So I'm going to fold it into thirds, like so. I'm going to use a little bit of tape, and now I have formed a triangle column with my paper. Three books. Can we do four? Oh, there goes our triangle column. All right, so our triangle column did three books and then crumpled with the fourth book. Let's try with our next shape. How about the square? Six books. Oh my goodness. Here goes book number seven. Eight. Nine. Ooh, there she goes. So we just saw our square column come crashing down on book number eight. Now we're going to try our circle shaped column. Here we go. Twelve books. Whoa! Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are at 22 books. Let's keep going. 29. 30. There we go! 30 books. Our trusty circle got to 30 books before falling to the ground. So why do you think that is? Why do you think the circular column was able to hold so many more books than the other two? So based on our test, we know that the cylinder, or the circular shaped column, was the strongest and held the most books. The reason that the cylinder can support the most books is because its walls don't have any edges. The force of the books cannot become concentrated in any particular area. The load is distributed evenly. So in other words, all parts of the cylinder are sharing the load of the books equally. All parts of the cylinder, therefore, contribute to its overall strength.
Congratulations, scientists! What did you learn today? I learned that a single piece of paper can hold up the weight of 30 books using a column shape because the weight is evenly distributed around all parts of the paper. Now, if you wanted to switch this up at home, you could try using different kinds of paper, or you could try cutting your paper into different sizes before you fashion your shapes and test which can hold more or less weight. I hope you'll visit us at our At Home Science page to find more experiments that you can use at home with everyday materials. See you tomorrow.